So today, we're actually going to start one of my favorite units, which is kind of a bummer because I would have liked to have done this in person with you. But, you know, it's going to be pretty cool because we're going to get to do a lot of real world stuff because I'm going to get to go out in the world and record some video and come back to you guys with some answers about the mathematical world around us. One of my favorite units is shapes, okay? Geometry. We're going to start that discussion today. We're going to start talking about shapes. We're going to start talking about geometry. Ollie and I are just standing outside in front of my best friend's house. We're about to go out to a job site with him. He's a real estate developer, which means he prepares the land around us to be developed upon, and then he builds stuff on it. We're about to go out to the job site to him, and I bet we're going to see all kinds of wonderful shapes on the way there, while we're there, if we make any stops in between. But just taking a look at this house, what shapes can you already see? Think about their sides. Think about their angles. How many shapes can you identify looking at this house? And at this trailer. Shapes make up the world around us. Everything that you see has a shape and has usually got that shape for a specific reason. Think about the wheels on your parents' cars. Think about how our houses typically come in squares and triangles. As we're exploring the world around us today, make sure that you're thinking about angles, make sure you're thinking about sides. We're going to talk about what each different shape is comprised of. All right, let's go do this thing. Okay, so we are in the truck on the way to the job site. You can hear Ollie in the back. He's along for the ride. Thanks, Nick, for letting us tag along. We are going to go out and we're going to look for some shapes. But the shapes that we're going to look for are for some specific ones, all right? We're going to go ahead and we're going to take circles off the table. We're not looking for circles today. Circles are their own special thing, okay? Today, we're looking for polygons. Polygons are closed forms closed by three line segments that meet at points called vertices, okay? The line segments meet at those vertices, and the measurement between those two lines creates an angle, okay? So we're looking for shapes that are going to be classified not really by angle, but by the number of sides that they have, and they're all going to be polygons. And they start with three, okay? Number of sides. Let's see how many you know. Let's see how many. I know them all. I promise you, I know them all. Ollie's not going to know any. He's going to repeat after us, though. I promise you. We'll see if Nick can keep up also. All right, so three sides. What's got three sides? Triangle, right? That's the easy one. Triangle, what's got three sides, Ollie? Triangles, okay? Now four sides is another easy one, all right? But you're gonna think squares. You're gonna think square, you're gonna think rectangle. But that's not actually the technical name that we're going to look for something that has four sides. It's qualified by having four sides. Nick, what do you think it's called when it has four sides? Not a square or a rectangle. Little, are you smarter?
Quadrangle?
A quadrangle, he says. A quadrilateral is actually the correct answer. But that's good. He went for the quad because that's what means four. Okay? See, he didn't exactly know the answer, but he found his way there by using the root words. Quad means four. Okay? Quadrangle would have been measuring angles, not sides. Lateral means sides. Quad means four. Lateral means sides. Okay? The next one is a special one because we have a government building that's named after this shape. It has five sides. If you're with your parent, they might know it. You should ask them, what's the government building that has five sides? It's a shape. My buddy Nick is a huge history buff. I know he's going to know that one. What is it?
Oh, it's a Pentagon.
The Pentagon. Pentagons have five sides, okay? Pentagons have five sides. You're gonna find that we repeat some of these root words, like gone, okay? And you're gonna find that the part at the beginning describes how many sides or angles the shape has. Okay? We've already done triangles, right? Three angles. Quadrilaterals, four sides. That are all lateral to each other. That's another important part of that. Pentagon. Okay? Ollie's trying to make up shapes in the back. Octagon is not actually one of them. But we'll come back to that, buddy. After a pentagon comes six sides. Six sides. This is where they're really gonna. They're gonna start to get a little bit tricky here. Okay. So six sides. Six sides. It's a hexagon. It's a hexagon. Okay, it's a common shape, but we don't see that many of them out in the world. Not as many as one that's coming up here shortly, and you're all gonna know of at least one octagon. Okay? All right. So then we have seven sides. Come again, it's gonna repeat that gone word, but it's gonna have a root word that means seven. And it is actually, let's see if Nick knows this one. This one's a tricky one. Nick? You got a guess for us while they're thinking?
Septagon?
He was very close. He knew that it had a P in it. It's actually a heptagon.
A heptagon.
Okay. Then we come to the eight-sided one. And we all know the eight-sided one. Hopefully we're gonna roll up on one here in just a second. But if we don't, I'll let you think about it. I'm on the road right now. Where do you think I might see an octagon? They stand up, they're on the side of the road, and they're red. That's eight sides. How about a stop sign? And a stop sign is an octagon. Oct. Where do you know oct from? Where you can connect oct? What's another thing that has eight connected to it that has oct on it, Nick?
I didn't hear the first part of the...
else in the world that has the root of oct that has eight with it?
Oh, an octopus?
Octopus, or Dr. Octopus. You guys know I'm a Marvel fan. Okay, so Dr. Octopus, oct, eight, octagon, okay? Come to one with nine. You think you can guess? A guess is better than no answer at all, right? I always say, if you don't know the answer, you better at least guess. What's something that has nine sides? Those are called nonagons. Nonagons. It almost sounds like it's not a shape. Nonagon. Nonagon. Okay. And then we come to something with 10 sides. 10 sides. It's going to come from the Greek root for 10. Okay, we went over it earlier in the year when we were talking about multiples of 10 and we were dealing with measurements and things like that. You think you know it? Let's see if my buddy Nick knows it.
I have no idea.
No idea. Decagon. A decagon. D-E-C. Decagon. Okay, yep, because of the D-E-C for dec. That's deci, decimal, okay, decimeter. All right, that's where that comes from. So we're gonna see if we can find those shapes once we are out on the job site. And we're back in Ollie's world. Okay, so we went out to the job site, myself, Ollie, and my buddy Nick. And I let you guys watch some of our car ride conversation because I thought that was fun, about the different types of shapes that there are, the different types of polygons, more specifically. We're going to go ahead and delve a little bit more into polygons. And I figure what we'll do every day is we'll do at least one activity where I go out into the real world and I apply what we're doing to something real in the real world. Okay? And then we'll do an actual mini lesson, kind of like we used to do in class. Okay? So today we're going to begin our conversation of polygons. We're going to start talking about geometry, which is, again, one of Mr. Hatcher's favorite units because I love geometry. I love building things. I love making things. And shapes make up the world around us. Shapes and measurement, angles, it all makes up everything around us. You'd be surprised. Everywhere you look, there are shapes. Okay? So we're talking specifically today about the Teak 5.5A. Okay, you should have a journal at home while we're doing this. I'm going to start sending out some messages to try to figure out how to get you guys some supplies to your houses if that's something that needs to happen. Maybe one of these days I might be able to do a supply run to drop off at least the basics, like some notebooks and things like that that you can keep going in, as well as some hard copies of things if we need to take that route. Okay. Books. We have the Go Math books in the classroom. I might be able to bring those out. I might be able to bring your interactive notebooks out. But we'll cross that bridge. If you have a notebook at home, go ahead and start using it now. On your left-hand page, go ahead and at the top of it, write 5.5A, geometry and measurement. And then directly underneath that line, directly underneath that, again, that's geometry and measurement. And then directly underneath that, let's go ahead and start writing out the rest of the TEAK. The student applies mathematical process standards to classify two-dimensional figures, shortened to 2D, by attributes and properties. The student is expected to classify 2D figures in a hierarchy of sets and subsets using graphic organizers based on their attributes and properties. Okay, that's a long way of saying that you need to be able to classify shapes by their characteristics, attributes and properties. Attributes and properties is another way of saying characteristics, okay? Somebody or something's attributes are characteristics that thing has. Properties are natural inborn characteristics, in this case of shapes, okay? But there's also properties of elements, properties of math. There's all kinds of different properties, and they're fundamental elements of that subject matter. Okay, so what do you have to be able to do? We've been doing this for a long time. What's the action verb? Well, you have to be able to apply mathematical process standards. So what is it that we're doing? We're applying. That's what we have to be able to do. And what we need to be able to apply is our mathematical process standards. Okay, we need to be able to apply our mathematical process standards. Okay, we need to do that in order to classify two-dimensional objects. What kind of objects? Two-dimensional objects. That means that they have width and they have height. They have two dimensions, but they don't have depth. They don't have something that goes away from, okay? They only have one way and another way. They don't have that third axis of forward and back, okay? So you need to be able to apply mathematical process standards to classify two-dimensional figures by attributes and properties. We just talked about what attributes and properties are. Hey, Ollie.
Hey.
Okay. You also are going to be expected to classify two-dimensional figures in a hierarchy of sets and subsets using graphic organizers. Again, that's just a fancy way of saying something simple. They want you to be able to classify shapes using their sides, using their angles, using their vertices. They want you to be able to classify your shapes by those different characteristics and attributes. And to do that, you may do that using a Venn diagram or other kind of graphic organizer where it says all of the sides are the same. Or it has this many sides and it has this many corners. And then overlapping in the middle, that's what a Venn diagram is. We'll look at one here in just a second when we talk about non-regular polygons and regular polygons. So go ahead. I'm going to let you take another look. Write this TEAK down. It is, pause your browser if you need to. It's also in Google Classroom and the Quick Note on Class Dojo. So you can find it there as well. But go ahead and write it down if you want to. Okay, at this point, you may be asking yourself or asking me or asking somebody else in the room with you, what is a polygon? Mr. Hatcher keeps saying polygon. Well, what is a polygon? A polygon is a figure that is closed by three or more line segments meeting at points called vertices. Okay? So while you're copying that down, I want to point something out. If you'll notice, you'll see that I have underlined the part of the word poly and the part of the word gon. Well, why did I do that? Why did I underline those words? That's because those are roots. Those are root words, okay? Poly and gon, they come from a different language that we don't speak, but it's what helps to make up our language. We've taken bits and pieces and roots from French, from Greek, from Latin, from German, from a variety of different languages, and we've used them as root words for words that we've created, okay? For instance, polygon. Well, poly, we know, means multiple, multi. Poly means multi, multiple, multi, multiple, multi. It means more than one, okay? And gon means sides. So we literally have a word that means multi-sided. Okay? And that's what our polygons actually are, is they are figures that are closed by three or more line segments. There's your sides, three or more line segments, and they meet at points called vertices. You might call them corners or points, okay? But it's important to know that they are called vertices, okay? So let's go ahead on the left side of our notebook and let's write that down at this time. Okay, so you should have written down the teak. You should have written down the definition of polygon. Now we're gonna think a little bit more about our polygons. So what shapes do you know? I've drawn a few of the polygons that we've talked about today. We've already discussed all of them that we're going to talk about today. You may or may not remember them from the previous video. It's not that big a deal because we are going to include them on this video as well. But I've included a quadrilateral, I've included a triangle, I've included a circle, which we aren't worried about today because that's not a polygon, right? Not a polygon. Okay, I've also included a pentagon and a hexagon. Okay, what are some real objects that have those shapes? In your journal on the left-hand side, I'd like for you to go ahead and write what shapes do I know and what real objects have those shapes. And underneath that line, for as many of our eight polygons as you can remember, I'd like for you to go ahead and list out some real-world objects that share that shape. For instance, we all know that an octagon is the same shape as a stop sign, okay? So since we all know that a stop sign is an octagon, I'm gonna go ahead and give you guys that one that you can use in your interactive notebooks. You can go ahead and you can write octagon, stop sign. So that's what I'd like you to do, is I'd like for you to take a second to write out each of the gons, the ones that you can remember, and go ahead and write real world objects for each one of them. Take a second to go ahead and do that in your interactive notebooks or the notebooks that you have at home, and then we'll move on. Okay, so now in your, if you didn't know all of the shapes, if you didn't remember all of the shapes, that's okay, because we're about to learn them again, okay? In your interactive notebook, go ahead and make yourself a table like the one that I have here, okay? The table that I have here has four rows and nine columns. The first column is bigger than the other eight. In those eight columns, on the seven columns to the right, we're going to draw a triangle. A triangle. A quadrilateral, a pentagon, a hexagon, a heptagon, an octagon, get in the octagon, a nonagon, and a decagon. Now, you might have noticed as we went along that the shape started with similar sides and angles, similar sides, and then became very unusual. Well, that's going to come into play when we talk about regular polygons and non-regular polygons here in just a moment. But for now, just know that a polygon can be any kind of configuration of those sides. Triangle is always going to be three sides, but there's different types of triangles. There's isosceles triangles, there's right triangles, there's scalene triangles. A quadrilateral could just as easily have been a rectangle or a square. All squares and rectangles are quadrilaterals, but not all quadrilaterals are squares or rectangles. The pentagon could have taken on a different shape, like the heptagon, nonagon, and decagon. All that qualifies this as a heptagon is that it has seven sides, and then the angles and the vertices that we're going to look at here in just a moment. So go ahead and draw out your chart. Polygons, sides, angles, and vertices in the left-hand column, followed by all of these empties with our shapes at the top. Go ahead and do that now. Okie dokie. Hopefully you have drawn your chart. If you haven't, pause it, draw the chart, and then pick up whenever you're ready to go. Okay, let's talk about these shapes. Let's talk about sides first. How many, you're gonna notice a pattern as we get going, so let's talk about sides first. On the polygon, on the polygon seen here, we know that this is a triangle. And a triangle has how many sides? Three sides. One, two, three sides. Okay, three sides. You'll also notice that it has one, two, three vertices, and the measurements from side to side at those vertices are going to be your three angles. So a triangle has three sides, obviously three angles, triangle, and three vertices. Okay? A quadrilateral, how many sides does it have? One side, two side, three side, four sides. How many vertices or points does it have? One, two, three, four. Four vertices. And because there's four vertices, the measure of the side to side is going to be our angles. And since there's four vertices, there will also be four angles. Okay. Pentagons, like the important building in our government. Okay, the pentagon. How many sides? One, two, three, four, five sides. Five sides the pentagon has. How many angles and how many vertices do you think that it has based on the pattern we've seen so far? Well, we've got one, two, three, four, five vertices. And if we have five vertices, would you say that it is fair to assume that we're also going to have one, two, three, four, five angles? Okay, I'm sure you can see the pattern here. Go ahead and look at your individual shapes at this point and write down how many sides each shape has, how many vertices each shape has, and of course, how many angles each shape has. I'm sure that you will find relatively quickly that if it has seven sides, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, that it also has one, two, three, four, five, six, seven vertices, and thus seven angles. For our octagon, It's going to have 8 sides, 8 vertices, 8 angles, and 8 vertices. For our nonagon, we'll have 9 sides, 9 angles, and 9 vertices. And lastly, for our decagon, 10 sides, 10 angles, 10 vertices. Go ahead and finish your chart now. Okie doke. You guys should have taken some pretty good high quality notes by now. We've written down the teak that we're studying today. We have written down a definition of a polygon with noting what a vertice is, what a vertex is. It's a vertex if it's singular, it's vertices if it's plural, if there's more than one. So we've written down a definition for polygon, we've written down the teak, we've noted what a vertex was, and we have quizzed ourselves on real world examples of the 8 polygons that we're focused on today, and we have just drawn a chart with all 8 polygons telling us how many sides, angles, and vertices each shape had. Okay? So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to do a little pop quiz here. Take a break. We're not going to write so much anymore. Okay? You're just going to draw a few shapes for me real fast. After you draw those shapes, you're going to label them as polygon or not a polygon. Okay? Let's start with this shape here. Pay close attention. Okay. Is that a polygon? What about What about this? Is this a polygon? Okay. Think about it for a second. Mull it around in your head. Are each one of these a polygon? You can pause it if you need more time, but we're going to go ahead and we're going to identify this shape here. Not a polygon. Why is it not a polygon? Well, it had 1, 2, 3 sides, but if you'll notice right here, those sides weren't, that polygon wasn't closed. Remember, in order for a shape to be a polygon, it has to be a closed shape formed by 3 or more line segments. That's a shape. It has 3 or more line segments, but it's not closed. Okay? What about our middle one here? Is this a polygon? Well, that's a little bit of a trick question because it's actually not a polygon because a line can't extend past a vertice. Okay? Uh-oh. Okay? But you could theoretically be seeing this as 2 polygons. 1 triangle and a 2nd triangle. So you might have seen 2 polygons there. That was a little bit of a trick question. And then lastly, this guy here is definitely a polygon because it's closed. It has 3 or more line segments. And it's a shape. Okay. All right. Time to move on. Okay. So earlier you might have heard me mention regular polygons and non-regular polygons. Well, what does that mean? You might be thinking to yourself. You can go ahead and you can make yourself a little title that says regular polygons on your left-hand side, and right next to it, another one that says non-regular polygons, and you can put a line right down the middle of it. Okay, right down the middle of it. A regular polygon is a polygon where all the sides and angles are congruent. A non-regular polygon is a polygon where not all of the sides or angles are congruent. Maybe all the sides are, but not all the angles are. Maybe all the angles are, but not all the sides are. Okay? Maybe some combination thereof. Whereas in regular, all sides and angles are congruent. Well, what does congruent mean, you might be asking yourself? Well, congruent, we have a definition over here. Congruent is when line segments have the same length or angles have the same measure. Remember that line segments get measured in length, whereas angles get measured in degrees, okay? So a regular triangle is one where all of the sides and angles are congruent, whereas a non-regular triangle is where not all of the sides or angles are congruent. Go ahead and write this down, and we will show some examples next. Okay, so next we're going to create this Venn diagram on that left-hand side of your page as well. Okay, this is the last thing that you're going to do on the left-hand side. You'll leave the right-hand side blank to do additional problems in or to take notes of your own. Okay, but the last thing that we're going to do is we're going to make this Venn diagram, because if you remember, the teak wants us to be able to classify shapes. As you can see, shapes in this circle are going to have congruent angles. You can see that this shape is a rectangle, so all four corners are going to be right angles. Okay, same thing here. We have three different rectangles. All four corners are going to be right angles, 90 degrees. But they don't all have the same sides. Notice in this shape, these two sides are much longer than these two sides. You'll also note these little markings. On those markings, you can bring your attention over here, and I have a blown up view, and I can tell you sort of what they mean. When you see marks like this, you need to find ones that are the same. When the markings are the same, they're telling you that those sides are the same. They're not giving you necessarily the measurement, but they are telling you that those sides are the same. In this polygon, this side, and this side are all different. This has one mark, two marks, three marks. Those are all different. But this side and this side both have three markings. That's indicating that those have the same length. Now, if it was doing an angle, you might see something along the lines of this. You might see a marking denoting one size, a marking denoting is the second, and a marking denoting the third. None of these angles are the same size in this shape. Okay? With that knowledge, we'll go ahead and we'll talk about these shapes. In this circle, these shapes are going to have congruent sides. You'll notice that this shape, this side, and this side are all the same. But these two angles differ from these two angles. In this shape, the sides are actually all the same. But these four angles, comprised of this vertex, this vertex, this vertex, and this vertex, those angles are the same, but they differ from this angle and this angle. Our shapes that are in the middle, where they have congruent sides and congruent angles, those shapes there in that sweet spot there in the middle, those shapes are regular polygons. You'll notice that this square has 1, 2, 3, 4 right angles and four sides that are the same length. This pentagon has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sides that are the same length, and that will result in 5 angles that are the same length. On the triangle, 1, 2, 3 sides that each have one marking indicating that they're all the same length
and 1, 2, 3 angles with one mark each indicating that they're all the same measure. So you have now classified shapes with a Venn diagram or a graphic organizer by their attributes and their properties. Okay. Excellent job today, guys. I hope that you are making good use of the lessons that we're going to post. Today was a little bumpy, and tomorrow I need to do 2 lessons to kind of catch us up a little bit. I'm also going to do 2 lessons on Thursday, and then we'll all be caught up at that point. Go back through this video, pause it where you need to pause it, make sure that you take good notes. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to email me at my school email address. Your parents are able to get that. I'll also post it to Class Dojo. This video is public to anybody who has the link, so I'm not just gonna shout out my email address. I will post that in the appropriate places. Alongside some activities that cover this material that you can do to reinforce the lesson. This lesson explained the material to you. You are more than welcome to go back and watch this video as many times as you want. I'm going to post a few different activities from GoMath, from the GoMath book, from the Engaging Math book, and I'm going to go ahead and always direct you to Education Galaxy. I'll go ahead and post the lesson. So that people who want to do it and want to see how they did can go ahead and do that and see how well they grasped the material. But again, we're not necessarily grading any of this at this point. You know, an interesting road ahead that we will conquer together. So again, this has been Classifying Polygons, Teak 5.5A. I love you guys. I miss you guys. I hope you're getting a lot of good rest. I hope you're staying safe. I hope that you are following all of the precautions that we're supposed to be following. And, you know, I hope I get to see you sooner rather than later. Stay tuned to Class Dojo, Google Classroom, etc. for more information as we go forward. Stay tuned, guys. We're in it together. Love you. Okay. Well, Mama Cass Elliott. Nobody can tell ya. There's only one song worth singing. They may try to tell ya, 'cause it hangs them up to see someone like you. In New Orleans, and it's called the Rising Sun, and it's been the ruin of many a poor boy. And God, I know I'm one. Jeans. My father, he was a gambling man down in New Orleans. Oh, has it always been this glam? I was a drab little crab once. Now I know I can be happy as a clam. I come from beautiful baby. Did your granny say to your heart? Be who you are on the inside. I need 3 words to tear your argument apart. Your granny lied. I'd rather be shiny like a treasure from a sunken pirate wreck.
scrub the deck, got rad, shining. I was falling like a wealthy woman's neck. Scrub the deck, don't you know? Fish are dumb, dumb, dumb. They'll chase anything that glitters. Beginners. Come, come, come to the hottest thing that glitters. Fish dinners.
I just love seafood.
You look like seafood.